Welcome back on Easter Sunday. I hope everyone's had a good day. Today I'm going to read a request from my grandson, well, my son actually, to read Grandma Joins the All Blacks. Wow, I can just imagine doing this. Not. Okay. On Monday morning, Grandma woke up at 6 o'clock. She put in her false teeth, dusted her wrinkles with her big feather duster, and dressed in granny clothes. She said, I think I'll make marmalade. Meow, said Scratch. There's Granny, there's Scratch. Grandma waved the wooden spoon. Tee-hee, she chortled. I'm going to be a good granny today. On Tuesday morning, Grandma woke up at 7 o'clock. She put in her teeth, pulled on her tracksuit, and dusted her wrinkles. Woohoo! She sang. Today I'm going to watch the All Blacks. She jumped on her skateboard and set off. Well, I don't think I'd be able to do the skateboard thing. Tried it once and nearly wasn't a good outcome. Next one. Not even Wednesday. At the stadium, she sat in the front row and took out her knitting. Knit one, purl one, knit one, purl one, knit one. The scarf grew and grew, but the rugby field was empty. I think I'll investigate, said Grandma. There was a loud noise in the changing room. Moo, it went. Hoo, and moo, hoo, hoo. What could be happening? Oh, dear. And there were the All Blacks, bubbling and wiping their noses on their sleeves. What's the matter, boys? Asked Grandma. We don't want to play today, Gran, they howled. Don't be silly, she said. There's a test match on Saturday. You have to practice. Imagine the All Blacks not practicing. We're tired of practice, they sobbed. She hummed. You need some of my marmalade. She took a jar out of her handbag and gave them each a teaspoonful. Gosh, must be good marmalade. They perked up straight away and jogged out onto the field. Grandma trotted behind, waving her rugby scarf. Hurrah for the All Blacks, she cried. When they'd finished, she made them a cup of tea. Well done, boys, she said. I'll be off now. Bye, Gran, waved the All Blacks. Thanks for the marmalade. Grandma did a wheelie in the car park and whizzed home for lunch. Oh, they look pretty tired and worn out now, don't they? Wednesday morning, Grandma woke up at 8 o'clock. She dusted her wrinkles, put in her teeth. I think I'll plant vegetables today, she said. The phone rang. It was the All Blacks coach. Good morning, Gran. The team won't get out of bed. What shall I do? Aha, said Grandma. They need a break. I'll take them rafting. Can I come? Asked the coach. Of course, said Grandma. Just give me half an hour in the garden. There's the coach. I wonder what Grandma was doing in the garden. She put on her wetsuit and flippers and went to plant the cabbages. When the All Blacks arrived, she flip-flopped onto the bus. Let's go to the rapids, she said. That night, Grandma fell asleep in her chair. She was still wearing her wetsuit. She's tuckered out too. On Thursday morning, Grandma woke at 9 o'clock. There was a knock on the bedroom window. It was the All Blacks. She put her teeth in quickly. Come in, she called, and they climbed in one by one. Oh my goodness, they came through the window. Good morning, Gran. We've brought you breakfast in bed, bagels and bacon. Said Grandma. She patted the quilt. Sit down, boys, she said. Gosh, it'd have to be a strong bed to hold all the All Blacks, wouldn't it? I wonder if Richie McCall was there. Where are we going today, Gran? They asked. I haven't dusted my wrinkles yet, but how about the circus? We could ride the dodgems and do a spot of tightrope walking. Yippee, cheered the All Blacks. We'll do the dishes while you get dressed. Oh, you are kind, said Grandma. She dusted her wrinkles and put on her circus outfit. Ooh. Wow. When the last All Black leapt off the tightrope, Grandma clapped her hands. "I'm hungry, let's get fish and chips." "Right," said the coach, "my treat." Everyone rubbed their tummies. "Yum," they said. Grandma drove the bus home that night. On Friday morning, Grandma woke up at 10 o'clock. She hummed to herself in the shower as she scrubbed her wrinkles and rinsed her teeth. A text message tinkled on her mobile. "Hi, Gran," it said. "We've got practice. Hope you can make it." It's becoming an everyday occurrence now, isn't it, for Grandma to be with them? Gran texted back, "On my way." She put on a shirt and shorts, popped an extra jar of marmalade in her handbag, and hopped on her scooter. She was just in time to join the haka. That night, she had dinner early and sat down to finish her rugby scarf. On Saturday, Grandma woke at 11 o'clock. She dusted her wrinkles, put in her teeth, and made a pot of tea. "Bee bop a doo da," she danced. "I'm off to a test match." She put on her best dress and the hat with the red roses on and rang a taxi. The coach met her at the stadium gate. "Thank goodness you're here, Gran," he said. "The captain's gone home with the chicken pox." The All Blacks were very glum. "Come along now, boys," said Gran. "A tablespoon of marmalade and you'll be just fine." They perked up marvellously. Somebody's getting a massage there. Must have a sore back. Gran's miraculous marmalade. "Gran for captain, Gran for captain," they shouted. "I'll need a uniform," said Gran. "Come along with me," said the coach. Grandma put on her All Black clothes and straightened her hat. Then she slipped her teeth into her handbag in case they fell out in the scrum and led the team onto the field. Gosh, even scratches there. Grandma's got her hat on rather than headgear. Grandma scored the first try. She grabbed the ball and ran and ran and ran and ran and ran. She was home late that night. There was a big party. Oh my goodness. She must be the hero of the story, I think. On Sunday morning, Grandma woke up at 12 o'clock. She dusted her wrinkles, put in her teeth, and went to the spa pool. When she got home, there was a queue of reporters at her door. They asked her a lot of questions. "All in a day's work," said Grandma. On Monday morning, Grandma woke up at 6 o'clock. She put in her teeth, dusted her wrinkles, and went downstairs for breakfast. "Not one jar of marmalade left," she said. She picked up the phone. "Good morning. Is that the All Blacks? Captain Gran here. I need you to come and help me make marmalade." Can you imagine Kieran Reid going to make marmalade with a grandma? And they did. That's a very funny story, isn't it?